Hello, hello to my earth signs, and welcome to the next installment in the 12 Days of Tarot. So if you are an earth sign, Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo, either your sun, your moon, or your rising, we are about to dive into some predictions for your 2021. So we'll start with a goddess from the Total Bitty Goddess deck. 90s icons portraying the goddesses to give a little divine feminine energy overlooking the entire year. So for a little divine energy for 2021, we have, earth signs, you have the same goddess guiding you as our water signs. So Hebe, Hebe. I don't know if I pronounced these names correctly, guys, because when you look up Greek goddess names, there's like 500 different ways to pronounce them whenever someone tries to do it online. So we'll just go with Hebe. And she is played by Isabella Rossellini in Death Becomes Her. And she is the goddess of eternal youth. So sometimes the goddesses come in for different readings for different reasons. So I'm going to go ahead and shuffle up our Holly Simple Tarot so that I don't confuse your Hebe goddess energy with the water sign message. It could be the same, but it could be different too. So a little Celtic cross spread with the Holly Simple Tarot to show us what 2021 has in store for the earth signs. We have an underlying circumstance of a Seven of Wands. So the Seven of Wands is a card of letting the bullshit fall away and letting your own light shine regardless of what the naysayers around you are saying. So Hebe's coming in with that energy of inner child, because as you're letting your light shine, it's coming from this place of innocence. It's coming from this place of being untainted by the opinions and expectations of the world around you. So as you are moving into 2021, it's really, really vital for you to turn inward and to find your center and your manifesto. You're trying to find what it is that you stand for, so that moving forward into the next year, no matter what the outside world is saying, you know where your center is, you know where your core is, you know what you're here to do. And that's a big ask, it's a big question, but that's okay, because you also have an energy coming in of the Ace of Swords, and that shows us that there's gonna be a spark of clarity. There's gonna be a little inspiration. I'm feeling it probably very soon in the year, in January. You're gonna have a little spark of inspiration as to what it is that you want to do to leave your mark on the world. How are you going to leave your mark on this year is a better way of putting it. And you're going to get some inspiration for that. You're going to really start to experience the world from a perspective that you want to share in some way. And it's going to be very uniquely you, but it's going to help others as well. So underneath this, the root cause is the Two of Cups. So that tells me that there is a relationship of some sort that's important on a soul level that's going to be helping with finding this truth, finding this mission. So yes, traditionally the Two of Cups would mean that there's a love relationship partner, a romantic partner that's coming in, that maybe you both share a common cause, and that's what really kind of brings you clarity, that that's what you want to move forward with. However, the Two of Cups can also just mean a really valuable and beautiful friendship, but it is like a soul level connection. This also could be for some of you or signs, I get a feeling that there is almost a spiritual energy around you, so it might not be that you have an actual physical partner that's involved in this, but there's some sort of spiritual inspiration. Maybe it's a past loved one that really stood for a cause. It could be that there was a health issue of a past loved one that you now want to stand up for, but there's a feeling of union. The relationship that connects you to the cause is what you're going to constantly be coming back to whenever you get discouraged. So it's kind of the heart of the matter. It's your pulse that's gonna bring you through things. Because anytime we start any sort of project or endeavor, There's inevitably going to be a time where the work becomes more overwhelming than the mission ultimately started as, and you have to be able to come back to that intention. That's why we set an intention in our yoga practices, because when it gets hard, you want to be able to come back to why you're there. And this relationship is going to be very key to why you're there. It's not going to be the type of scenario where someone that you love is into something and you pretend to be into that thing, and then you get down the line and you're like, actually, I don't like this thing. It's a common love that comes together naturally. It's not something that you have to force. There's something about your love for this person that inspires you towards this cause. And the goal is the Nine of Cups. So the Nine of Cups is blessings, love, just everyone involved getting everything that they want, wishes being fulfilled. So it's a beautiful goal to have. So this definitely does have an element of sort of charity work behind this energy, but it doesn't necessarily have to be like volunteering or something like that. There are so many different ways that you can serve a cause. You can serve a cause by, you know, spreading the word. You can serve a cause by donating money. You can serve a cause by donating your time. You can serve a cause by embodying what it is that you're trying to promote. So there are different ways that this is going to come about, but there is an element of being of service to others and ultimately letting that be serving you. Your past is coming in with the Eight of Pentacles, which is the card of mastering a craft. So I do feel like there's something that you're already really good at that's going to come in handy with this endeavor. So you're not going to be like recreating the wheel. You're not going to start at square one and be like, oh, well, I was a baker and I was really good at that, but now I want to be saving the coral reefs. Like, it's not going to be a leap like that. It's more like, oh, I was a baker and now I want to get involved with feeding the homeless. Like, those two things feel like they could go rather well together in a certain way. And so there is an element of you having an area of expertise in something that may not be directly related to what you're getting into this year, but it's going to really be supportive of it in a certain way. So know that you're not going to have to start fresh. You're not going to have to wipe the slate entirely clean. The skills that you already have are going to help with this mission. The future card is coming in with the Four of Wands, which is a card of celebration and celebrating the littler milestones. So this is saying that this is probably going to be a big project, a big endeavor, which, I mean, we're moving into the age of Aquarius, all of us. So hopefully, in theory, we're all going to have these global missions that we're now getting our energy behind. The lesson with the future is you're not going to win the whole war at once, but the battles that you win along the way are going to be really valuable. So your lesson moving into the future is not only A, that is going to happen, you're going to win lots of battles, but B, make sure that you celebrate those victories, because that's going to keep you motivated moving forward. So the two things that you need in moving forward into this mission are the connection to the heart, the thing that makes you really, really feel connected to this mission that you can come back to when it feels hard, and celebrating the small victories along the way so that you don't get discouraged that you're not at the end goal on day two. So your energy is coming in with the Seven of Cups, which indicates that there is a lot of emotion behind this topic for you, which makes sense because, as I said, you want to make sure that you're connected to your heart so that you maintain your motivation as things get hard. But the Seven of Cups is saying that there might be some times that it feels a little darker getting involved in this issue. You are going to be confronting emotions that need to be confronted. So just know that if you get really emotional on occasion when talking about this topic or fighting for this cause, that's a good sign. It means that it's connected to your heart. But it also means that you need to make sure that you're really practicing self-care as you move into this. And know when you need to rest and not quit. Know when you need to pull back and really take care of yourself and connect to your spirituality so that you can move forward and continue for this cause. So that's your energy. The outside world is coming in with the energy of judgment, which isn't as harsh as it sounds because it's actually the energy of forgiveness. Earth signs, it's so beautiful because you're known for being so stable and so logical. But for 2021, connecting to your more watery, emotional, heart-based sign is going to soften the heart of the world around you. I could say more on that, but I feel like that's really what I'm supposed to say in regards to this judgment card, is that the more that you can really let yourself feel, the more the world around you would feel. And it almost feels like, I know a lot of people say that when they see like strong older men cry, that they just have to cry because it's so odd to see these like strong, stable figures show emotions. And Earth signs, I think that's what you're giving the world this year. I think that you are learning to tap into that heart space and really be connected to something that calls out to your heart so much that your emotions can't help but show. And the world's gonna be like, whoa, wait, the really tough old guy is crying, and now I feel like I need to pay attention to this because clearly there's something important emotionally going on. Apologies, Earth signs, for calling you the tough old guy, but the metaphor works. So this is definitely, this feels like a big soul mission. To let yourself be vulnerable emotionally and to show the world that vulnerability because of this cause, because of, not just for willy-nilly, it's showing the emotions because this is going to resonate so deeply for you. You're gonna care so much about this cause that it's okay to show the emotions because those emotions are gonna get attention. And then the hopes and fears around this are the Six of Swords. So the Six of Swords is a triumph after a hard time. So it's kind of mirroring back to celebrate those small victories because there are gonna be plenty of victories along the way. Ooh, I just got a little earth sign hit. I know someone's watching this video and it's an environmental cause that you're going after. And yeah, it's gonna be a really beautiful way to integrate your personal skill set into this cause. The outcome of your 2021 year spread is the Two of Wands, which means that there's gonna be beautiful, beautiful action, beautiful wishes fulfilled, and some really great connections made along the way. The Two of Wands indicates that there's a spiritual partnership. And again, we kind of come back to that Two of Cups energy, that there might be a spiritual energy around you that's inspiring you to this cause. The Two of Wands is taking that spiritual energy and making it that much more passionate. So we're coming almost from this arc of this place of being connected to an issue, but not really knowing how to move forward, not really knowing how to show the emotion. And then slowly that unravels throughout the year and you get the hang of it. And it becomes this place of power and passion. So rather than coming from this place of, oh my God, I'm so emotional and I can't believe that you people don't care about this cause, at the end of the game, it's gonna be this beautiful, just like warrior. Like I just keep seeing like flashes of these like magazine spreads of like the change makers of the year or whatever. And you're gonna be an inspiration for others to take action in this area. So the reason that we have Hebe as our goddess, it is a little different than the water sign reading. For you guys, my earth signs, this is saying that you are being called to call out your inner child because you need to have that inner child optimism, believing you can make a difference in the world. So whereas my water signs were about playing with that inner child and doing something that was, you know, a fun pastime from their childhood, yours goes on a deeper level with Hebe in that it's about your emotional state and the way that you're viewing the world. And you really need Hebe around to be able to tap into the idea that one person can make a difference. So why not you? I hope this reading has served you well, Earth signs. We have more in the 12 Days of Tarot still coming up. So if you are watching this on any format, please like, subscribe, share. If you enjoy the energy of the goddesses, Total Betty Goddess Deck is for sale over at michelleshaywalker.com/shop. And if you want to support these videos and these unfoldings of this 12 Days of Tarot, you can head over to patreon.com/michelleshay and help to support more content like this.